The last 40 years has had such remarkable advances in strength training and bodybuilding that teens today are almost like a new race of superhumans compared to back when I was in high school. Even the star football player in my high school team, if compared to people today, he'd be at most a DYEL or otter mode. In this video, I'm going to talk about the reasons for this amazing advance and also what some of the consequences might be. There's teens today who have better physiques after 2 years of lifting than I did after 20 years of lifting, and they're like 300, 400% stronger. It's literally like they're a different species. Let's look at the reasons for that. The first is equipment. When I was in high school, our school did not even have a gym, and it was a huge high school. We had over 1,000 people. Only the school teams, like football, had access to a gym, and it was one of those stupid universal machines. So we did not have access to equipment. And back then, teens did not go to gyms. It just was not done. The second reason is information. When I was in high school, it was the pre-internet era. There was no good information at all about how to gain muscle, get stronger. You had to go to the library, and those were mostly academic, hard-to-digest books. The magazines were out there, but they were ridiculous because they didn't mention that the workout routines they were promoting were for steroid users only. So any natural user that tried to use those workout routines would suffer from overtraining and not get any results at all. So that's the second reason, lack of information. The third reason is performance-enhancing drugs. Back in the 70s, when I was in high school, it was something that only professional athletes did. It had not worked its way down into high schools and teen lifters. So what are the consequences of these amazingly rapid advancements in strength training and bodybuilding? Well, let me tell you what I suspect. Let's cover two separate areas, muscle gain and strength gain. So let's start with muscle. A perfect example of this is Sam Sulik, who at age 20, 21, is more muscular than the Mr. Olympias of the 60s, 70s, and 80s. And he's just 21. I mean, think what he'd be if he was Mr. Olympia age. My guess is that, unfortunately, people like Sam will die before age 40, and here's why. Teens can get away with taking massive amounts of steroids, but as you get older, it becomes more and more dangerous. Steroid use causes blood pressure to go up, it causes arteries to harden, their cholesterol levels become horrible, it causes the blood to thicken, which increases the possibility of deadly clots. And these things just get riskier and riskier. And as the person keeps taking steroids, the same dose that they were taking when they were 20 can become fatal at age 30. And that is what I suspect happened to Jo Linder. Now let's take the super strong, like this guy whose tagline is the natty aesthetic powerlifter. But let's look at the consequences of lifting that heavy of weight. Now, this guy is lifting incredible amounts of weight. I mean, like 300, 400% of what I did at my peak. Joints are mechanical. The heavier the load on the joint, the more it's going to wear out. So my prediction is that people this strong are not going to make it much past the age of 30 before they have ground away all their cartilage and cannot lift any longer. The less weight you lift and the better form you use, the longer you can lift without having joint problems. Now, what I can say from personal experience, I'm 62 and I'm still lifting. I have a number of problems, which I'm going to list here because I've mentioned them before. So my lower back problems, I had those before I started lifting. That's just a genetic issue I have with my lower back. My right shoulder has no cartilage. Now, that is most likely because of my years of overhand serving and beach volleyball. If it was lifting, it would be both shoulders, not my right shoulder. Now, my knee issue is because autoimmune diseases run in my family. I'm actually very fortunate. I just get rheumatoid arthritis in my knee maybe every 10 years, and it goes away. It's not related to lifting, but that is something that does slow me down on occasion. I actually have no joint issues that I can specifically trace to lifting weights. I credit the fact that I was a weak bodybuilder that I have good joints because I use good form and I didn't lift heavy weights. So my prediction is that these young, really strong guys are not going to be active in bodybuilding much past the age of 30. But you know what? I might be wrong. This is all uncharted waters, as I said. We're going to find out for sure whether taking massive doses of steroids and becoming, you know, 250 pounds of muscle when you're 5'6", if that's going to lead to death by heart disease. We're going to find out if lifting like four times your body weight in squats and deadlifts, if that's going to cause joint issues. But, you know, you need to weigh your options. If I had to venture a guess as to, you know, a good middle ground, people always ask me, so how can I work out without destroying my joints and staying healthy? Well, first of all, cardio, cardio, cardio every day. That's part of staying healthy. Nutrition is a huge part of eating healthy. Eating your vegetables and fruits and eating minimally processed foods, that's a huge part of it. And then as far as the working out, probably, I mentioned this before, I think probably what would be optimal for minimizing joint wear while maximizing physique gains would be to do like a full body workout twice a week. But you know what? Don't take my word for it. I'm just guessing here. We don't know the answers. So there you have it. The new race of superhuman teens, and they are going to provide us a lot of data in the upcoming years. Thanks for watching. Auf Wiedersehen.